letting and giving and inviting a people to hold on to this way and this way of life, then you will be attaining a reward because you are bringing people. من دل على خير فله مثل أجر فاعله. So this work of da'wah is the work of every single person in whatever is in your capacity. If you invite somebody to the masjid, you will also get the reward. If you invite and encourage somebody to do sadaqah and to do charity, you will also get the reward. If you invite somebody, do not belittle any good act. Any good act, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. If you giving an invitation for a person and that day he changes his life, then you also have attained great reward. You also are building your bank balance of the akhirah. If you tell a person that do not despair from the mercy of Allah, there is a verse in the Holy Quran which gives hope to every individual. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Whomsoever commits fahisha, lewdness, ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ, he remembers Allah, he makes istighfar, فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ, he does not despair from the mercy of Allah, he turns to Almighty Allah Ta'ala with a repenting heart, فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ, nothing can stand between a person and tawbah and repentance. He is asking and pleading to Almighty Allah Ta'ala to forgive him for his sins. فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Who is the one to forgive sins except Allah? وَلَمْ يُسِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا. But then he is not obstinate in what actions he was doing. He keeps away. He has made tawbah. He has made repentance. He has made istighfar. He is amending his way. He is changing his life. He is coming back onto the Quran and is emulating the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then who? وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Allah Ta'ala, none can forgive a person sin except Allah. So may Allah Ta'ala accept your sitting here. May Allah Ta'ala give us the tawfiq to realize that the work also of this Ummah welfare trust actions and what they are doing, all of that when you see the presentation, to enable and to make us realize how and to appreciate the so many ni'mah and bounties that Allah Ta'ala has given us, where despite that we are enjoying our ni'mah, despite that we are enjoying our bounties, remember on that day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, a person, everyone, and I will conclude with this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We explain how frightful a day it is, Qiyamah, the earthquake and the convulsion of the hour. We know that people on the day of Qiyamah, they will be running here and there. Everyone will be concerned about his own affair. No person will come to your assistance. It is only who comes to Allah Ta'ala with a sound heart. And in this state and in this condition, on that day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah Ta'ala, a person will be asked these questions. He will ask about his life and hayatihi. How did you spend your life? So this life that we have is also a test. And we do not know when it's going to end. It can end this very night. It can end to... No person knows. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدَى وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. Allah Ta'ala will also ask us about our youth, shabab. Shabab and the age and this prime of age where many youngsters, they could have been engaging in many other sinful activities. They could be engaging in many fahisha, but they kept away from it and they knew and understood the purpose of life. So much emphasis has been given and rewards for those people in the prime of their age, abstaining from fahisha and from sinful activities, not going close to anything that may cause them to indulge and commit great fahisha. So they abstain from it, they reward, everyone will be asked also, and shababihi fima abla, how did he spend his youth? Not only that, when you have been given knowledge about certain matters in the deen, you will not be asked how much knowledge you acquired, but maza amilta bima alimt, how far did you practice on the knowledge that you had acquired? So knowledge, whatever you acquire, we ask Allah Ta'ala also to give us knowledge. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ilman nafi'a, knowledge which is beneficial, وَرِزْقًا وَاسِعًا, and the rizq and sustenance which is wasi'a and wide. A person will also be asked about his sustenance and rizq. مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبَ وَفِيمَ أَنْفَقَ. How did he acquire his wealth and where did he spend his wealth? So here is an opportunity. Shaitan is promising poverty. He is promising إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانِ يَعِدُكُمْ الْفَقْرَ. But here, a person on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, he will also be questioned, how did you acquire your wealth and where did you spend your wealth? So this is an opportunity. We are also grateful to Sheikh Imam Muhammad Ismail for making us possible to come here at this Brighton. Normally we visit Brighton and people come here for normally to visit and see the beautiful sea that we have here. So, and here you are coming to such an important, and you are saying that there is a vibrant community here in this area here in Brighton. And we make dua that Allah Ta'ala make it easy for the people that are living here to remain firm on deen and iman, and also to know that we are all part of the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that Allah Ta'ala give us the tawfiq and the istiqamah. Most thing is istiqamah. We should ask Almighty Allah Ta'ala to give us istiqamah and steadfast, because on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah and when we leave the dunya, those who say, our Rabb is Allah, thumma istiqamu, and they are steadfast. Steadfastness is a very beautiful, important, that we ask Allah Ta'ala to give us steadfastness. Istiqamah, that you are on the deen and you want to remain firm on deen. So istiqamah is steadfastness. One person came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he asked for advice. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Qul amantu billah thumma istaqim." You wanted such piece of advice, no need for any other advice. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him a very comprehensive answer, that "Qul amantu billah thumma istaqim." Say, "I believe in Allah," and thereafter remain steadfast. Steadfast, fastaqim kima umirta. Imagine Allah Ta'ala is commanding the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, be steadfast on what you have been commanded to do. And if you are steadfast, the reward is so great. What will be the reward? تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ Malaika and angel will descend, and they will give the glad tidings. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا Do not be grieved, do not be sad. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي And glad tidings of the Jannah which has been promised for you. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءَكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا We are your awliya, we are your protectors in the life of this dunya and in the akhirah, and for you is whatever you desire. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسَكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورِ الرَّحِيمِ So all action that we do in this dunya, increase in our iman, and most important, do not turn away from deen and remain steadfast. Allah Ta'ala accept you.